Yes.
Hey.
This feels like a...
What's up?
This feels like a reunion, man.
Yes, it does.
I think it is.
So good
well,
to see you again.
I've never met you before. Oh,
nice to meet you.
Hey.
I'm Urban.
That's Urban.
Yeah. Hiya, hiya. And for those who are watching or who are listening, hi, welcome back.
Yes.
We miss you.
We back.
I miss you. I hope you miss me. But I'm not alone as far as I know, man.
No. So, we have a full group to talk about sex tech, and sensuality. What was it again? That's it, right?
Well, mostly.
Right.
Sex and actually all the developments around sex.
Yeah.
Sex tech.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, yeah, I'm here also. Case.
Case.
And, yeah.
But
who are you again?
Me?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm Terry, man. Just
so
Terry.
We got Terry.
Yeah.
Is it Terry Temptation? Temptation Terry? Or is it just
I think
Terry?
It is.
I think it is.
It's Temptation
it's
Terry.
It's one of my personalities, yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Got to do with all their egos right here, man.
Yeah, well, we will have to talk about that some more after you introduce yourself.
Hey, guys. I'm Amina.
Yes.
Zina.
Woo! She's in the building.
One and only.
One and only.
Girl from opinion-wise.
Temptation yeah. Terry yeah. And Amina Zina.
I've been spotting some stuff. Like, she was asking a lot of people some awkward questions. And
yeah.
The reaction to it was hella nice.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly. That's. I heard that. She did that very well.
That's what we do.
Yeah. Make perfect. People.
Hitting the streets.
Yeah. So, okay. Well.
Welcome to Blow My Mind. We're going to sit here and talk about ways to blow each other's mind and what's going on with the latest sex tech news.
Yeah.
I think awesome. Terry should start.
I didn't have anything prepared. Did you?
To one
did
person.
You prepare shit?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know.
You did. I'm the only one who...
Yeah, but you're the guest, so it's okay.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah. Ladies first, right?
Ladies first.
Well,
I, think so.
I don't know if this is sex tech news.
Okay.
But it's sex news.
All
right. Y'all know about Harvey Weinstein, right?
Oh,
yes.
Yeah. His settlement reached $44 million.
Wow.
Yeah.
So he gets to settle, though.
Yeah, that's what I was like, what? Mm. It's tentative. But, like, who's
sounds
getting this
like
$44 million, though?
I don't
like
even know who's this guy.
Yeah, the people. The people who accused
no,
him.
No, I didn't.
You know the whole Me Too movement,
oh,
right?
That guy.
That started
yeah, sorry.
With that guy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, yeah.
Yeah, the $44 million, I would think, goes to all his, the guys
victims.
And girls' victims, yeah.
I just don't understand why he's not in jail.
Yeah, because...
Like, he's a legitimate predator.
Yeah, people...
Like, he's not somebody that's, like... safe around people regardless of how much money he has, like that's not
yeah
he's gonna do it again. He's been doing it.
Is that's the problem with this society? People just settle and people are addicted to money, and even if they get are a victim of something and they get presented with a couple of million dollars,
yeah, it doesn't
it's
feel
like okay,
it doesn't feel like justice has been served, to be honest.
Yeah,
like, it feels like he's getting away with it, giving the people the idea like as long as you pay a lot of money you can get away with anything,
right?
That's
but that's the
American
truth.
Way
that's the truth. Yeah, that's just how it goes. It's terrible, but it happens.
What's the deal with someone like Cosby? I mean, like, as far as I know, he's behind bars, right?
Yeah.
Yeah,
he's probably going behind bars.
No, he's
probably
behind bars.
It's probably the same reason. It probably has to do with money, that he wasn't he didn't have the means to pay everybody a couple of million dollars. But it's hard. If you would ask yourself the question, if you were a victim, would you just push on and not accept any amount of money, or would you?
I'm gonna take the money,
right?
But
yeah.
In my head, I'm thinking I would want to like this guy.
Yeah, of course.
Exactly.
But of course, they feel the same way. They take the money and then they still don't like the guy. But they say, all right, for these couple of millions, I will just. Yeah.
No,
yeah, but that's
around.
Already happened.
Jail for life. If you can't control your dick to the point where you're like attacking people over and over again, then like you should probably be behind bars because you're an animal.
Yeah. The problem.
You know what I mean? You gotta go to the zoo where you belong. Yeah. Like for real.
I agree, but the problem is and has been with this guy is that he had so many supporters, like Oprah for instance. Okay. There are lots and there are lots of. Movies or I should say more footage out there.
He had a lot of influence as well.
Yeah, and they all praised him. Like, he was the best guy and nobody who wanted to release that movie. Harvey Weinstein came in and he did it.
Man.
And I think all the lawyers involved are just focused on keeping the peace and not really getting justice.
No, they're just like... want people to stop talking about it.
But I do think his career is of course destroyed. He will never be able to produce another movie. And yeah, but the question is, how is it guaranteed that he will never prey on some girls again?
He's gonna do it again.
Probably,
he's
right? Like if you
again.
Are like if you are a pathological liar, you can say, all right, I'll never do it again. But if that's in your system, you'll do it again. You can't even help it. It's just like the person you are. So
human nature.
Your nature. So, yeah, I just hope they just throw a lot of psychologists and people to analyze this behavior. Yeah, but it would probably amount to nothing, right?
So
I think he should be behind bars.
It's kind of sad. That's still. It. I agree.
The discussion, right?
Yeah, like, he should be behind bars. Bam.
And if this was like you know the 1800s, you know, the guillotine,
right?
Just hang him.
Yeah,
like, that
or
sounds
not.
Terrible, but like or I know not. That if that was me.
I don't think, if you're talking about the 1800s, I think way worse shit happened in the 1800s and nobody ever found out because there was no media and no, like the women's rights in the 1800s were probably like non-existent.
But if it had happened, like the females would have all the rights to go after him and do that.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Well, no, but okay, yeah.
The value, the level of mind-blowingness of this item was really mind-blowing indeed. Because
I haven't
like,
even heard it, yeah.
Like, I didn't hear it from it as well, but it certainly blew my mind in a way, like, seriously? So, like, you just pay $44 million and you just get away with it and be like, yeah, have a normal, happy life or something like that?
Yeah.
Yeah, like nothing happened.
The American Probably. Court system. I mean, I'm from America, but even if you're not, you know how it is over there.
Well, yeah, I just found out.
I wonder, it's that jury system. There are people in there... And there must have been a court date. And how can these people be convinced, right? How could the jury is like always like a couple of random people, right?
So if you have $44 million, you can probably pick your own jury.
Maybe, right? There's probably some corruption going on. Yeah,
some. Anyways, though. Yeah. Next topic.
Next topic. I think we all agree that this is not something that that is good for the world. But
true.
So do you have another thing to blow our minds?
Yeah, I think I do. At least I'm going to try.
Yes.
Like, how's your sex life, by the way, guys?
Well, I think it's okay.
Yeah.
I mean, in the beginning of a relationship, you're like rabid
you're like
dogs.
Yeah.
You're like, all right, let's do it all the time. And then after a couple of years, it's like. Like three times a week, I'm happy with that. So,
all right, cool.
Yeah.
How's yours?
How's mine? To be honest,
it sucks.
Yeah.
Right now it does.
The problem right now is like, oh man, parenting life is so killing for your libido. However, there's still porn sites, and thanks to the beautiful people of Kiro, I still have a lot of possibilities.
Right. Thanks to this
which
arm.
I'm not going to talk about right now. But right. However, how's your life?
Yeah, it's kind of okay. I fuck when I want to.
Okay.
But my libido is just low, man.
Yeah, same is with me. But
I don't know why. I don't know what it is. Maybe it's the weather or something. I just
It does have something to do with the weather.
Just not in the mood.
When the sun is out and everybody's doesn't have all their clothes on, then your libido will probably go up.
Yeah.
Well, in addition to what we're talking about right now, it turns out a lot of people want to have a lot of sex, but it turns out they don't have as much sex as they do want to.
Yeah.
So, for example, in Britain, more than a half of the male and females, they have less than one time a week sex.
Yeah,
and that's mostly due to the influence of the mobile phone.
Mm.
Turns out we spend more hours on our phone, which makes it impossible for us to like equally have as much sex as we want to.
So
in our mind, we're trying to have as much sex as we want to. Unfortunately, due to the fact like we're Instagramming, snapping or whatever, Facebooking, maybe even gaming for that matter, it turns out like there's not as much sex as we want to.
Yeah.
In my situation, it's mostly due to the fact like, oh man, I'm just hooked up on the PlayStation or hooked up in my laptop making beats and stuff. So that's why.
Yes, it's true. There's so much distraction, like so many other things to do.
Yeah, like
that might get then sex goes down the list, right?
Yeah,
so,
true.
Yeah.
So like the moment that like the moment my kids are sleeping, I'm like, yeah,
let's make a beat.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'll be like, I could tap that ass.
Yeah.
Hey, the PlayStation is looking at me and be like, yeah, you haven't touched me for a few hours. I'd be like, yeah, let's do that.
Yeah, shall I create another child or shall I create a beat? Okay. I'll make a beat. I think beat is wiser.
Yeah, true. And it also turns out I was quite good in it as well. Yeah. So I'm like, man, if I tap that ass, it might be 9 months later, I might have another bundle in the oven.
Yeah, right.
So how's your sex life, Amina?
Oh, no complaints.
No complaints. So, like, you guys are not in the category I was talking about right now, then?
No, yeah, it depends. I do recognize that at the moment my libido isn't, like, through the roof. So I think it's probably that thing. It's probably all the distractions, like...
Minus the children.
Like the phone, minus the children. Yeah, and also I don't have the children, and even though, and right, if I have the children too, then, I won't have sex anymore at all.
But you have to have sex to make children, right? You
right.
Know, right?
Right. Yeah, okay. Okay. Yeah.
I wonder if the people of Kiro, if their libido life is cool as well, you know, because like mostly they're developing all these interesting gadgets, you know, to increase the quality of your sex life.
Yeah.
But I wonder if the quality of their own sex life is cool.
I don't know.
I think it doesn't, because they make the toys to upgrade their sex life, right?
Yeah.
Do you think? I think a lot of people prefer using toys versus actually having sex.
Well,
to be honest, based on the amount of toy shops in Amsterdam... And I'm like, how do these stay in business?
Yeah.
There's like hundreds.
Yeah, but people use them as a couple also, right?
Yeah, yeah, that's
a
what I
lot of
wonder
people
about.
Use them as a couple.
Do people as that's a true. Couple use them more, or do people who are just alone use them more? I
don't know, but I know you don't have to make breakfast for a pocket pussy. So
yeah.
That's
right.
A plus.
Yeah, true.
Indeed. I think also, like, if you consider, like, there's a lot of socially awkward people, especially in Amsterdam, because, like, you know... Smoking weed and all that makes you kind of like sheltered or something like that.
What? No way, man. When I smoke weed, I get horny as fuck. I feel like, hey, I smoke a joint. I'm like going through the red light district. I'm like, no, I'm in a relationship. No, I can't do it. Okay, but this looks good. And when I'm just sober, I'm like, wow, why are all these? No, just leave me alone. This is a whole different side to me. But okay.
Like, well, what I noticed with some people, they mean like they shut down as soon as they smoke. Maybe they're not smoking the right stuff or something like that.
Probably.
Or you're not smoking the right stuff.
No, but it depends on the person.
Oh, for real?
Yeah.
It depends on the person. Like, everybody has a slightly different reaction to any kind of drug. So,
I don't get horny of smoking.
I get super horny. I don't get as horny as I used to get.
But how come? Because you're always high.
No, well, I think, you know, drugs just let your inner self come out, you know? So when I'm like normal, I'm like behaving myself. And then when you take some drugs, it's like, okay, I'll just act like my inner self, and I won't think about all these rules like you were supposed to act. And then I get rebellious and horny.
That's what I got with alcohol, you know? Like the moment I drink a few drinks, I'll be like... Yeah, I like everyone right now.
Yeah.
You know, I'm not in my...
I hate everyone.
It's even worse with how do they call it, Molly or ecstasy, like...
Oh, man.
They call it the law drug for nothing. Yeah. I actually did this with just some people in the town I was living in that I didn't like at all. And for I don't know what for reasons, and I didn't have sex with them, for the record. but it was like, I don't really like you guys. And I don't understand why you're acting this way. I just felt I didn't feel like I belonged there. But once when somebody gave me something, I was like, okay, it's not so bad. Oh, I understand you, of course. I don't know why I was so strange and I was so thinking that you didn't like me. And that's really true.
It's like
I'm glad I did that day. Like it really changed my whole perspective on those people.
Yeah.
So
interesting.
Yes.
Next
nothing,
item.
Nothing wrong with experimenting a little. Yeah, I also had a thing with a celebrity who, and of course, I already heard a lot of men admitting this. Like I saw Terry Crews on Dr. Phil admitting he had a sex addiction. Ooh. But now Jada Pinkett Smith also reveals she had an addiction to porn.
Oh, yeah, wow. I heard something like that.
Yeah, like here, like there's a whole movie connected to it, but you just have to Google it to see it for the because the people who are listening can see it. But yeah, so yeah, I think this is a very like a thing that's real nowadays, especially with kids growing up with internet porn. Like when I was born, I couldn't. I had little magazines in the closet near my dad's bed where I could find a Playboy or Penthouse, maybe a Hustler. Then you were really lucky. Like, whoa, these are your actual sex scenes. Wow, Hustler really went for it.
Seriously, so the pages didn't stick together or something like that?
Yeah, some did, some did. But I don't know if it was my cum or my dad's cum.
Oh,
you share.
We probably
sharing is caring, right?
Well, it's going.
You shared the same sock.
It's going
also
to a real strange place now. But we're talking about. Well, there's nothing wrong with sex and not watching it in a magazine or watching it on porn. But of course, it can. I think that's another thing. People have less sex with each other because it's so readily available. Like. You don't have to pay for it. Like you have like a couple of sites who just stream it for free. I must know that's probably not the best quality. You should probably go to a Pornhub and get a subscription for the best quality porn. But it's so easy that I think I had a porn addiction as well. Not when I come to think of it, when once I saw all these people talking about it, I thought, well, especially in these days that I wasn't in a relationship, I was like, I'm horny. Okay, I have to go to my room and get this off. You know, get this.
Yeah, one. But the when firm grip. When are you like addicted?
Well, I think when you do it a couple
that's
of times
a, very good
a day,
question,
I guess.
Way.
Yeah, that is a good question. Is once a day is that already addiction?
I don't know.
Yeah.
Once a day is addiction?
Yeah. I think so.
Yeah, I don't really watch porn though.
You don't watch porn?
No, not really.
I'm so proud of you.
Like maybe once a month, once two yeah,
well,
I
like
month.
To think
no,
I'm okay because I do know a couple of guys who have, but yeah, I don't know. I don't know if I should judge it. So, on the one hand, are you an addict if you have like a list of your favorite porn actors and actresses you want to see and you're searching them? Like,
are you an addict or a fan?
Yeah. What is it? That's
could you
question.
Be like a fan of a porn star, just like you're a fan of like a musician?
Yeah. I'm quite curious right now. Do you have favorite actresses
well,
right now?
Well, I wanted to say my habit is more like okay, I'm interested in see a new actress for example, and I'm like, oh, she's kind of nice, and I watch one video, and then I maybe do the search like I found out the name, like oh, this video has actually her name in it, not just brunette getting fucked. All right, this one. Okay, so now I know the name. I will search it once or twice, and I have this thought in my mind that I think, wow, this might be a fan of this girl. Like she's doing it well. But you know what always happens after a couple of months? It's like I used to have in my normal relationship. I'm just bored with her.
Yeah,
it's
okay,
I knew somebody new now. And
well,
then
actually, there is one that I can call like. Well, it never gets bored. It
all right.
Never gets bored.
Yeah?
Call it.
Ever heard of Adriana Maia?
I think I did.
No idea.
She's awesome, though. Yeah? She's awesome. And I think she's a newcomer, though I must say, like, there's a lot of movies, so... Yeah,
maybe
yeah
but
she's,
you said she's just real productive.
Yeah, but you already said it. She's a newcomer, so I wonder if in 6 months you will say the same. You will give the same answer. Yeah.
Well, to be honest, I've been checking her out for a few months already, and it's not like I'll be on the porn, be like something like that. But the strangest thing is like with a certain selection, some will always pop up back. It's like watching anime and be like, you're going to check out some new stuff, and then all of a sudden you'll be like, man, you know what? Yeah, I haven't seen the new stuff, so let's just check out some old classic ones, you know?
It's exactly like that, yeah. So
I think it's interesting because you don't really hear about a lot of girls being porn addicts.
Right, the point was next to being addicted maybe, or just fan, I don't know what it is. Yeah, it's kind of rare that you hear girls talking about being...
They don't talk about it.
Most girls you talk about, they never say they watch porn. Like, it's something... Like it's something mostly exclusive to men.
Yeah,
you know?
I really can tell.
So I'm kind of proud
if women watch porn. I don't even know if women watch porn.
They definitely watch porn.
Yeah,
well, that's why I love the artist Summer Walks, because she made a song like "Girls Need Loving Too," and you know that, and she just simply explains the way, like, it's also the girls who just want some serious D, you know?
I think,
I think you know what it is too, is like girls. Like, men are way more visually stimulated than girls.
True. All right.
Yeah. Like, obviously, we care about looks, but if we're not feeling the situation, like, it's probably not going to happen, right?
Yeah. I just read somewhere over 30% of the porn visitors are female.
Right. Yeah. Oh, so it's definitely happening. I think first, women didn't admit they masturbated. Now, well, we were there already. Now everybody just admits that everybody masturbated. But maybe that's something for 2020.
To be honest, it's okay for
women to watch porn.
Wasn't there research that showed out that women are thinking more about sex than men do at one point? I remember there was research about it.
Could be.
Probably when they're when their biological clock starts ticking, it's like, I need it now.
Next time I might check out the source from it, but I could remember there was something like that. Yeah. More due to the fact like you just mentioned, like, we are visually triggered, and mostly with women it can be like just half the toss of it.
And I must admit as well, most of the porn is very from the perspective of the man, right? So it's not really romantic or something. It's always like a game or a role play, and most of the time the girl is very not submissive? Dominating
submissive.
Oh, and what are you doing now?
Yeah. Not like that. Yeah.
Oh, so you come to fix my pie, but I'm fixing yours.
So that's something that maybe there's more room for, I think, that
but you have porn now, right? Like the female friendly porn.
Is that a thing?
It's a thing. I don't know if all women watch that.
Oh, well, hey, I beg to differ at one point, because like, if you have like the category of women who you can who you can put in the selection of cougars, mostly of them, they're not submissive. Most of them are serious dominators.
Yeah.
Serious dominators.
I think
we need to switch to the next one.
Subject. Okay, is there somebody in line or?
No, man, there's something else in line, man.
Oh my God.
Oh, yes.
I move. Hey, let's
Why would you do this to us?
Because toasties are always cool.
Toasties are always cool.
Love it, man.
Are we still doing right now?
ASMR action.
Okay, we're live. I love it when we don't pause when we're eating, because this is also, we already said that, this is also for the listeners' experience, that you maybe get off while
you're fucking hot, man.
Maybe in 20 years.
Thank you.
In 20 years, we can develop televisions where they can also experience smell and be like, oh man, I want to get one of those grilled cheese.
You have it already.
Actually, aren't there people that like to have sex while eating? Isn't like a thing? Like a fetish?
Like fevers?
Yeah, true.
Yeah.
I think the fetish is more that you watch people eat and then you just
we had a talk about that, right?
I think so.
Recently.
For real?
Yeah. I remember like one of the podcasts we were talking about, like the link between eating and the fetishes you can grow into it. Like some food, for example, can like really make you aroused.
You have certain types.
I mean,
of
like
food.
Everybody knows the eggplant and the peach.
Yeah.
Talking about it. Yeah. That's what we're talking about. It was like we used to do an herbs versus case where we used to create a food.
Yeah.
To make sure that we get people into bed, right?
How is the thing called in the shell, which is also known aphrodisiac? It's like a little snot in a shell.
Oysters?
Yeah.
Mm. Oysters,
what
I mean. Yeah.
That's also, they also say that you when you eat that.
Yeah, I think it's bullshit though. I don't know.
Maybe it has to do with a vibe around the food. If it's like exclusive or rare or special, because I think because ever since oysters got more readily available, I think nobody.
Well, to be honest, that's something I will never find out because I'm allergic to shellfish.
Mm, yeah,
so that's fine with me. But actually, like most stuff, you know, like for example, eating a lot of chocolate can also do a lot of good jobs.
Yeah.
I love chocolate.
Yeah, no, me too. What's not to love about it?
When I was in middle school, we practiced putting condoms on bananas.
Mm. Seriously?
Yeah.
Oh, right.
So you can use bananas, cucumbers, zucchini, sausages, hot dogs. If you safely may be fetish objects because they have a phallic shape and can be substitutes for dildos, useful for vaginal or anal presentation. Mm. Penetration. Mm. So yeah.
So it's just...
That's food play.
When it looked like a dick.
It's all good.
Yeah, it's all good.
But what
when
if it
tastes
breaks?
Like pussy, it's all good.
Yeah, well, just make sure you wash the cucumber before inserting it. Mm. You get a nasty.
Will do, man. Thank you. Will do.
So how's the grilled sandwich?
The
kindness invites me to eat a donut.
Why don't you
donuts? You don't like the toasties?
Oh, no, I'll get to that.
All right.
But yeah. I'm just throwing donuts.
It's an appetizer.
Yeah, it's better to take the appetizer, maybe the donuts first. Yeah.
Yeah, man.
Shout out to JD.
I did. I'm the trendsetter here. And on that note, I will. It kind of has to do with the same thing you were saying. Only this is really kind of different. This says millennials are having less sex. But only because we've raised our standards. So you would expect that they would say because of a phone, because of the phones is probably also true. But it's also this article states that that people are raising their standards, and it I think that's also true. But it also has to do again with internet.
What you see on
you
the
see,
internet,
you can see everybody. Like you
everyone's
don't have to deal
perfect, right?
Right. You don't have to deal with just the people in your village. You're like. Oh man, this guy's not attractive. I like this guy.
I like this guy from Groningen.
Yeah, I like this guy
with
from
his
Groningen.
Guns.
Yeah, with his guns, man.
Suns out, guns out, man.
Look at these guns.
But you know what? I think people have been having sex forever, and definitely having casual sex. Obviously, or we wouldn't be here.
Right.
But this is what I was thinking. Like, remember when Woodstock happened, like the '60s and seventies?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Before that, like in the '50s, everyone was like really family oriented, like Christian. Mm-hmm. Like you gotta wait till marriage.
Yeah.
Right. In the '70s, like all this like have sex thing just started.
Yeah.
And I don't think we're that far away from that. You know what I mean? Like I feel like people only
history
been,
repeats.
People are more conservative because maybe they're seeing like okay, all this casual sex isn't leading to like the best situations because now everybody's single and childless and like going into 30s and 40s and not being married, you know?
Yeah, right.
So you know what I mean? Like maybe
not having
this
shit together.
Yeah.
It's more like it's also what you guys said. It's getting more normal just to have casual sex, but as more normal as that gets, there's also the movement against that, like you said, like normal people start thinking again, maybe we should wait to have sex after we're married, and then it just repeats itself, you know?
Yeah,
it's just like it goes from let's all have sex to no, let's just take it easy, let's all have sex, let's take it easy.
I think there's way more conservative people in society, though, overall. True. Like, you know what I mean? When you think about like the entire Middle East, you know, like that's like a huge population of the world. When you think about just like, I don't know, like even where I'm from. In the States, it's very much like wait till marriage. Like the whole southern United States. Not that people do.
But
you know, people at church can't be doing it, but it's still that idea is there.
Right.
But
a lot of people got married.
Isn't that like mostly like people who act like they're not watching porn sites, but in the end they actually do something like that?
Yeah. It might be.
Because
then you
to
get
be
the
honest,
crazy
like
people.
Yeah. Because you can't tell me like with people being abstinence, for example, in church, you can't tell me like they don't have the human nature, which urge inside of that.
Yeah, but you said, they probably do it in private or behind closed doors.
Yeah, but they like marry at 18 years old just to fuck.
Word.
They might, yeah.
Yeah, they do.
And then they get divorced.
Yeah, and then they get divorced.
It's like that song by some guy.
Who?
By Space Case.
he did a remix. He's like a singer guy. It's like a singer guy. Frank Ocean.
Frank Ocean.
He did a remix about
maybe you can sing
just
a little bit.
In the hallway. But he did his own spin on it, and it was like getting married in the States or something, and he explains that he remixed Hotel California with his own lyrics, and then it's about the people in America just get married way too soon, and then they get divorced.
Yeah.
So that's why divorce is also such a common thing now, because people just get married.
They marry because of horniness.
Man, there used to be a point when it was so trendy, like normally when you get divorced, it's like... It's going to be a very painful process. Nowadays, people celebrate to get the divorce.
I'm free again.
Yeah. Be like, I'm off the market again. Come and get me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
My child is at his dad's.
Yeah.
Come over. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So I would say. Yeah,
or at his mom's. It's yeah.
Yo, it's.
It depends. It's just. It's not here.
So can I do another attempt to your mind?
Yeah,
of course. That's
nice, man.
Lock and load.
Bump it up, man.
This certainly got me like really in a way of like, seriously, what the, wait for a minute, fuck. But however, turns out ecosexuals believe having sex with the earth could save it.
Yeah, it's crazy. What the fuck?
But you actually,
seriously.
It's crazy.
So you actually put your dick in the ground?
They're like kissing trees and shit.
Okay. Yeah. From skinny dippers to people who have actual intercourse with nature, eco-sexuality is a growing movement taking a new approach to combating climate change. If you happen to find yourself in Sydney this week, you have the unique opportunity to have sex with the earth. Just
tree
need to stop by
on
the eco-sexual.
On a new level.
Yeah, like...
Whoa.
The title of JC's song "Fuck Up the World" it's got a whole new dimension.
Yeah,
to this
right.
Seriously.
Yeah.
I don't think he was talking about that. Literally.
No.
But maybe he does.
Maybe.
So like, how is it gonna save the world though?
So basically, what it comes down to is like, they believe like being one with nature will actually increase the quality of the earth itself.
Yeah, I think it's just for their own mind, you know?
Yeah, I think so, too. It's more just, like I'm doing my art and I'm doing my part.
Yeah, and I think it's more to please their own mind.
And to be rebellious.
Because actually, when I start reading it and while I'm in the setting like that, I'm just like checking out this plan right here.
Then
can I say this, though? You know, like as far as climate change...
I'm gonna take another toast here. You should keep eating because I will eat them all.
I will definitely eat another one.
Okay.
But here's the thing: is like I feel like humans really think climate change is gonna happen, but like I'm pretty sure the planet would get rid of us before we like mess it up. There's been all sorts of other species before humans. Like I'm pretty sure, like if we keep acting up, the world will just wipe us out and be fine without us.
Yeah, but that
you know
happen.
What I mean? Like, that's just what
start
I think.
Start over. History repeat.
I think the Earth is stronger than humans. I don't know.
Of course, that's true. But the whole discussion about climate change is to prevent the Earth from getting rid of us.
Yeah, it's not like we fuck it up.
But
it's
you're
more
right.
Like we're gonna die.
Either way, the planet will fix itself. I think. Yeah.
It'll fix itself.
I think the chance is bigger. I think the chance is bigger that we destroy ourselves in this. Instead of the earth destroying us, the earth will be there.
Yeah, I think so.
Right.
Staring at me.